how are capital gains taxed? The first question we have to answer is whether the gain or loss is short-term or long-term. If you hold the asset for more than 1 year between you buying it and then selling it, it's long-term. Up to 1 year, it's short-term. If you only have a short-term gain, that amount is included in your taxable income for the year. That means short-term gains are taxed at your marginal rate. If you have a net long-term gain, that is taxed at a preferential capital gains tax rate. If your taxable income is less than a certain threshold, your long-term capital gains tax rate will be 0%. That's right, tax-free. That threshold is $40,000 of taxable income if you're single and $80,000 if you're married filing jointly for 2020. A long-term capital gain between $40,000 and $441,450 for single filers, or $80,000 to $496,600 for joint filers, is taxed at 15%. Much better than the ordinary income tax rate you'd face at those levels of income. This is why we say we have a preferential capital gains tax rate for long-term capital gains. In general, if you have an asset that you know is going to appreciate, you are better off holding that asset for at least 1 year and 1 day in order to get the preferential long-term capital gains tax rate. Otherwise, you'll pay your higher marginal tax rate on short-term capital gains.